Would it be a sin if I can't help falling in love with you?
Hello, guys, and welcome back to the Football Manager 2020 Sunderland career. As you can see on screen, we are starting with the main menu homepage. We have been offered a new contract from Sunderland. Beautiful, same money. And I thought this would be a very bright start to this episode, which will hopefully be a brighter episode, as you'll see in a minute. We're going to accept that. I don't know if it's 2 years or 1 year. Oh, that's the wrong screen. As we go to the league table, this is the conditions we're in. As you can see, we've already got a playoff place confirmed. There will hopefully not be any playoff games. Hopefully we can win the league or come second. It looks like we are with 16-point gap. But that brings us into today's episode. If you haven't seen the last one, please go and watch it before this one because it will decide everything. But we've played four games off-screen now. We'll show you these ones. We've started off against Accrington. Scott Fraser scoring and Max Power with a penalty early on. Then we struggled for the rest of the game. It was a very even one, this one. But we got the win, and that's all that mattered in that one. We brushed aside Accrington, but then it wasn't a brush aside against Peterborough, as Ivan Toney put the hosts in the lead with a penalty in the 16th minute, only for Harry Cornet to get another header, Balogun to score, and then Jason Kerr to get another header. The centre-back has been shipping in goals for fun, and although we paid a lot for him, he's turning out to be very good for us. And then the next game was away at Luton at Kenilworth Road. It was quite disappointing one. Cornick, with, you guessed it, another headed goal, only for it to be cancelled out by Sonny Bradley's headed goal. I think he's a centre-back and captain. Disappointing there, but we went on and I played a fourth game, that's four, against Shrewsbury at home. Max Power scoring a thunderstrike. He always scores just good goals. And Neil Faraguia, I think he came off the bench as well for injured Cornick, who was on a good run, scoring like four or five. He got injured. Neil Faraguia came on, scored two. And the reason I played that game is because here, at Roots Hall against Southend, who are doing pretty decent, they only sit out of the playoff places by 1 point. If we win this game, and I think it's MK Dons or Oxford drop points, sorry, we might just need to win, we guarantee our place in the Championship for the 2021-22 season. Beautiful. So if you haven't already, smash a like on this video because I'm going to bring you the team sheet for the next game that can do so. So here is the team sheet for that decisive game. We've got McLaughlin, Net, Emmanuel, Paddy O'Connor and Joel Lynch as centre-backs, as the other two are suspended from too many yellow cards. Then Townsend on the left, Max Power and 09 in the midfield. Gerard Henderson on the right this time for Harry Cornick, who's injured. Fraser in the middle, and Faraguia is on the left because I don't want to use many loan players because we're going to go into the Championship next season with a bunch of loan players that will be recalled anyway. But then again, we're not taking Balogun out of the team. He is an absolute goal machine. We've got Embleton and Robson on the bench, youngsters. Watmore comes back to the bench because of our lack in wingers, and hopefully we can be in the Championship after this next game. Oh, it's come early. One of my favourite parts about Football Manager, when you've got a team lower than the Premier League. Premier League teams releasing players. I'm going to have a look at all of these. These will be for free if we can get any of them. They don't look the best at the moment. Hopefully we get another batch. I'm not sure. Maybe the next batch will be like players who are older who's been released. But I'll get scouting these and see if there's any gems. Oxford have done it. Oxford have secured their spot in the playoffs. Oh, I don't know. I think we just have to win this next game. I can't see anyone catching up with us in six games time. I can't see MK Dons catching us, definitely. I mean, they want the best team when we played them. We beat them 5-1. I think we drew with them the other time, so fair dues, but contract's expiring. I just want to get into this game and I just want 3 points. Max Powell with a corner. This looks like it could be the moment to go up. Oh, Joel Lynch as well from centre-back, who hasn't played much with the shot there. Bishop, the goalkeeper, I think, that just got bought from Man United in real life, but Balogun has picked up on it. Florellin Balogun, we're going to miss him so much next season. Power struck his own man, but it's fallen to Josh Emmanuel. He's put it in the hands of Bishop. Bishop to whip it up again. All the highlights are coming through him. It's gone to Astley. I don't know how I'm saying that name. Scott Fraser to Josh Emmanuel. Going to play it around the back here. I love the little passing moves that we do. Even irrelevant passes, I just like them. I mean, Holloway's got Grimsby doing it now in real life. Paddy O'Connor going back to the keeper, McLaughlin. No mistakes here from you, please. Don't want to slip up. Paddy O'Connor in the defence. We really need a result. It's gone back to him, though, and they're running at us. Keeping the pressure up us. Up the far of the pitch on us as Luke 09 comes forward. Puts it over the top to Florian Balogun, and it's a bad shot for his liking. Shaughnessy to Jasper Humphreys. He's got round his man. Joe Lynch has headed it out. Max Power can run with it now. Keep going, Maxi. Go on. Keep going. Oh, he's got Balogun in support. He's hit it himself. And I don't think that was the best option. Dehana with another chance. Headed away from Gerard Henderson. Our little youngster on the right wing. Milligan. Back to Dehanda. Please say we're offside. It doesn't look like he is, Butterfield. And I think that's the highlight. Bishop. Oh, please, someone tackling Dehanda running at us. Gone to Astley, who's gone over the top. Emmanuel cut it out, though, and it's a good tackle from Max Power. Good player he's been this year. In contrast to the last years he's had at Sunderland, Henderson picks up on the ball. He goes infield to Max Power. He tries to chip it to Faraguia. It almost fell to Balogun. Faraguia's got another chance, and the keeper should have saved it. Neil Bishop, but that doesn't matter. Neil Faraguia has got a goal for Sunderland, his 12th of the season. These have been a good signing as well for that wing. And as things stands, we can rent that party bus out because we are going to the Championship. That's half-time. We've almost had 20 shots in just the first half alone. That is insane for a League One club against another one that is fighting for promotion. We just need to hold on. If we do hold on, we don't need to fight anymore because we've got it. Max Power to whip the ball in. Paddy O'Connor's been tucked down, and Max Power is not going to take a free kick this time. He's going to take it from the spot. A penalty after our centre back Paddy O'Connor was tucked down. Max Power, he can wrap things up. Please don't miss this. He's put it in the bottom corner. Max Power with a goal, two goals, his 13th of the season. What a player he has been this season. Very underestimated. Beautiful finish. Goalkeeper didn't dive enough. And it looks like we're off to the Championship. Throw in from Josh Emmanuel just before Elliot Embleton's going to come onto the pitch. Putting his youngsters on. Max Power to whip a ball in for Aguirre's. There he's got his second of the game. Max Power with an assist. His 13th goal of the season. It's 3-0. And it's the Championship for us next season. Corner from Max Powell. We can't make it four, can we? Ozadube has missed it. It's gone to Paddy O'Connor. He can whip a ball in from centre-back. And Robson just wide from the youngster. And it's over. 31 shots in the game. We've done it. We have done it. We couldn't do it with Leeds. We couldn't get Leeds to the Prem. We lost his job before we could do that. But we've done it with Sunderland. We are going promoted to the Championship. Hang on a minute. Pivotal game is MK Dons 5-1. I'll doubt that. I'll say his pivotal game was beating Stevenage 9-0 because since then, the run we've been on is amazing. Oh, we've done it. We can relax a little bit because we've still got the league to go for with Oxford behind us. We've got a budget as well. What's his budget? 2.1 million. That's lower than last year. Saying that, we did fork out a lot of money on some irrelevant buys. I mean, irrelevant in, of course, in retrospect to the money that we spent on them, not on how they perform. Sunderland are in the Championship championship next season. And we've still got two more games to play. Rotation on the cards for this next game against Charlton away. As we've already got Championship, it's 2 days after, so I've rotated heavily. Got McLaughlin and net. 09's at right back with Paddy O'Connor and Tony. I'm guessing you guys have forgot this guy. He was on loan from Tottenham. I stuck him in my under-23s because I thought it was a bit of a panic buy, a panic loan. I just saw his price tag and I thought, well, he's going to be some good, so I'll go for him. And I forgot about Van der Berg, who who is on the bench for us. We're going to give Tony a try because we can't go a full season without playing him. Townsend's at left back. Power and Ethan Robson in the middle. What more? Fraser and Embleton through the middle because of Faraguia, who's tired. And then Henderson's going up front because this whole team now, apart from Tony, is not loan players. And as I've said before, we want to be taking a team into next season that have had experience in this league at least. So Gerard Henderson, the youngster, is off up front. Clark to whip a free kick in for Charlton. It's just gone over. I don't know who got the head on it. Good chance for them. Williams to whip a free kick in. He's a good player. Maybe a player that we could take to the Championship with us next season. Although Charlton are still in the playoffs, so they've got a chance of going up themselves. They'll probably want to win this game to cement the playoff places. We want to win it just as much to cement a win of the league. I mean, we are 7 points clear, so I can afford to put a bit of a rotation side out now. As Duncan Watmore stole it off the defender, he's running through on goal. And Phillips has saved it. Half time. Nothing probably at all to shout about in that half. It's been a very even game. Very, very, because this team is fighting for their playoff place. And we've got to fight for our winning place. So I'm going to get onto the players saying I've got faith and hopefully a goal can come in this half. Nothing, and I mean nothing, is happening in this second half. We haven't had a highlight. Football Lagoon on. Got something here. Chris Solly with a throw into Will Grigg. Solly to whip it in. Paddy O'Connor clears it to Digby, but Henderson's got there before him. As you can see, I've just subbed him off for Balogun. Hopefully he can score. He's a bit tired though, so he's give it to Max Power, who's drilled in. It's just gone wide, and I think that is going to mark a 0-0 game. Might be wrong here though. Will Grigg, Luke 09, has missed the tackle. Grigg's put it into the box. Fraser's cleared it. Balogun's on the end of it. We're counter-attacking a lot in this game. Balogun just whizzed past the defence, left them for dead, and he's put it in the bottom corner. His 33rd goal of the season, assisted by Scott Fraser, but he takes all the credit himself. Balogun, what a run. Shredded the defender, shredded the keeper. Let's have a look at this. Jason Pearce left for dead. I don't know who the other defender is. He's just put it past Phillips to give us, hopefully, a 1-0 win at the death. And it is. A 1-0 win. That may be pivotal if we're going to win the league. A 1-0 win against the team in the playoffs. Away at the Charlton Stadium. 92 points, 7, the gap is 7, we've still got a game in hand as well. What's this? Grayson, I think he's manager of Charlton. Not going to listen to him at the moment, rather focus on the match, do all this press conference stuff, and we've still got a game left against the team that battered us earlier on in the season, which is Fleetwood. Big news before I go and tell you this next game. Peterborough have been relegated to League 2. That is a big shock from FM right there. Same with Fleetwood sacking Joey Barton. Where are they in the league? They are 11th. But, I mean, we've got them next. I thought they'd keep the manager for top of the league. So here is the team for the game against Fleetwood. McLaughlin in it. Emmanuel Flanagan and Kerr, who have got a good partnership now at the back. Townsend on the left. Power and Luke 09, who have got a good partnership as well. In the middle with Faraguia, Fraser and Barlow just a bit up from the middle. And then Balogun's up front. Barlow's back in the team because I think the other guy's not injured. It was tired. Gerard Henderson and Ethan Robson and Duncan Watmore. Duncan Watmore's injured and I don't want to play Robson in this game because we're fighting for the title. This is an important game and we need to win. Start the game here. Krellin whips it up. I thought as soon as I took kickoff, the highlights disappeared. Something must be happening right here. As Morris gets the ball in the first 20 seconds, Hill has gone over the top to Paul Madden, who scored two against us last time, I think. Madden running through, gives it to Sowerby, who gives it to Coots. Don't let him shoot. He has done it. He's hit the post. Thought it was odd that the highlights just carried on from kickoff. The away side coming close as Max Power can whip a ball in here. It's gone over the top. It's hit twice and it's blocked in the box. Max Power gets the ball out wide to Flanagan. He fits it through to Balogun. What can he do with it? He's gone to the side. Luke 09. It's gone over Hill, who's missed his header for Aguirre. Power strikes it. It's the bar. Aidan Barlow's keeping it in though. Tom Flanagan whips it a bit far to Power, who strikes it. And he almost scored another worldie. Still got it, and it's out for a corner. Half time. Dominant, as always. Time to dig in. We need to win the match to keep Oxford off our tails. Jesus, that was the quietest second half of them all. 25 shots to 4. We didn't win the game. Can't be disappointing because most of us defenders actually got the best rating. They're disappointed, though, that I've said I'm happy. 0-0. Now in the same games as Oxford. We've got an 8-point lead. And maybe off-screen, as I played the games, three games, I think it is, against Burton, Gillingham and Coventry. Hopefully I can wrap up the league off-screen. You might be thinking, why am I going to do that off-screen? It's because we're going to come back for the game against Hull, which we can evaluate all the players, look at who we want to buy, and just get into all the fun stuff at the end of the season as we prepare for the Champions next season. If you have enjoyed this video, please like, comment, share and subscribe. And I will see you all in the next episode of the Football Manager 2020 career. In a bit. Peace.